is that day. Today's that day, homie. Today's that day, Hans. Hans. Warte uns locos forever. Warte uns locos forever. I wonder if I could just get on Instagram. I could just put the video on Twitter. Warte uns locos forever. While I come here yesterday, I was like, this boy probably know my family. He gonna talk about what you got in your cup. I was like, don't tell nobody. Don't tell Rita. Don't tell Rita. I got some mountain to do when it's 9 o'clock in the morning. Anyway, it's Shantae Brown Sugar Talk under Black Unicorns. And today it's all about nerdy hobby. So I'm gonna talk about my nerdy hobby, which is basically Ayurveda. And I want to get like an Ayurvedic certification because it'll like help so much with like me cleansing your body and doing stuff for you, all this different stuff. So let's first talk about space. So today it's like space and nerdy hobby. So space, deep clean living space to release stagnant energy, and that is the truth. Have you ever just like came in and you just like got a pile of papers up off the floor and it's like it feel like a dump and all this stuff, and it's like you actually take the papers out to the trash, do everything you need to do, and then you come in and it's like it smells like lemon and pine saw. So that's it, like that's cleaning the deep space. I'm sorry, my YouTube hasn't gone live yet. Hey y'all, it's Shantae Brown Sugar Talk under Black Unicorns YouTube live. Space, that's what I was just talking about. And nerdy hobbies. Today is that was so deep clean living space to release stagnant energy. And that's what you're gonna do. And it'll get the funk out too. Get the funk out of there. Get the funk out. Nothing but the funk. Okay, declutter and release unused objects with gratitude. And that's it. You have to. Like, I'm just all about, like, I like this shirt. So I gotta get rid of some of my clothes. So it's like I gotta get rid of the clothes. They gotta go. Bring natural seasonal scents into living spaces. So like I do the lavender, lemongrass, peppermint. You know, those are like the three I keep with me. I'm gonna tell you guys about a new one today, and I'm gonna try it too. But because I have allergies or whatever, and I don't have issues with breathing. Like today I woke up, I had like a little cold, I had like a little phlegm. So I'm gonna go get some ginger or something. I got some ginger tea at the. So I got ginger tea. I might just have ginger tea later on this week. And that's it. Organize the clarity and calm. Organize your shit. Organize, homies. Organize, sisters and brothers. Organize. Next, take note of where and when natural seasonal light enters your space. Like, I'm such a natural light person. I prefer... So like, so this is a studio, so it's like unnatural light, but I would prefer lamps in here. Like, it doesn't always have to have this light unless, like, we recording, you see what I'm saying? So it's like, even that would, like, give it, like, a different dynamic or ambiance or whatever, because these lights will cause you to have seizures. All you gotta do is do a slow motion video and you'll see how the light blinks, you know, because you don't get to see how it blinks because your eyes don't really recognize it anymore. But yeah, sometimes you gotta create an ambiance. Store away any past seasonal decor in a beautiful and organized manner. And that's so when you go to it, it is for you. That is for your sake. That is for your sake, darling. Because, like, when you go back, you want it to be nice and all that stuff. Again, that is from the UK. The next thing is the questions. Questions to ask yourself. And let's go ahead and ask ourselves these questions. I don't know what today's section is today. We did finances yesterday. Okay, people. Whose opinion do I value the most? The opinion that you value the most is yours. Why are people in my life important to me? Why? Ask yourself that. Who makes me happy? The best compliment I've received is, I would like people to see me as someone who, how can I have helped other people? Do people's opinions influence my actions? Who do I look up to? Why do I look up to these people? Do the people in my life make me happy? And if some of those answers to the questions are no, then that's when it's like time for you to move away from people. Y'all understand? It's like sometimes y'all hold on to stuff that you don't have to hold on to. Okay, so now let's talk about nerdy hobbies and then I move into the Ayurveda. Okay, so nerdy hobbies, comic book collecting, laser tag. Oh my God, I saw this thing today. It's so cute. So what you do is you take a paper towel and you draw a heart on it. And then you tape it to your chest. And then whosoever heart shows, you gotta shoot them in the chest with water. And whosoever heart shows first, you gotta fold the paper towel over too. So whosoever heart shows first, that's who wins. I mean, that's who loses. Y'all see what I'm saying? So it's like you just like squirting, like you play with water guns. And you can probably do that like in different parts of your body too. So that's it. Laser tag. What the heck is LARPing? What is LARPing? What? Y'all do stuff I don't even know. I haven't even heard of that. What the freak is LARPing? Oh, live action role play. Oh, that might be cool. That's what they do that at, they make costumes for it at the other makerspace in Dallas, like in Carrollton, Texas or whatever. Cosplaying, special effects makeup, board games, trivia, fan fiction. Fan fiction is like, you know, you might want He-Man to have kids. You know what I'm saying? She-Ra's his sister, so She-Ra might have kids too, and she might marry a common man, and like, you know what I'm saying? Like all that different stuff. So, arcade games, geocaching. I said geocaching yesterday. I did not know that was a nerdy hobby. Reenacting, rare DVD collections. Oh my God, I would collect like the worst fucking movies ever. Like, so when I die, y'all could just throw them away. But it's like for real, that is like, I love it. Like Machete, I told y'all about Machete. It's horrible. It is a horrible movie. I like horrible movies. I'm not joking. I love them because I'm just like, y'all gave him money for this? It is like so funny. You gave him money to make this? Oh my God, it is like so funny. Funny. You know what else is horrible? Godzilla and King Kong. Like, these are horrible. And you don't, we would just be like watching them. It's like, this is so fucking funny. Okay, yeah, and that's it. So, special effects makeup. Then they say special effects. Yeah, they already said that. They said it twice. Magic. Magic is nerdy. Trivia. They said fan fiction twice, too. Yeah, oh, yeah, they said it twice in video games. So that was a nerdy hobby. So, like, for real, if you, makeup is a nerdy hobby too. Like, if you know a lot about something, that's, you just a nerd. Like, you know, that's like what a nerd is to me too. I heard that on like a podcast and I was like, that's the truth. Like, oh my God, I don't think I'm being recorded right now. That is the truth though. It's like, if you like know a whole lot of something, then it's probably because you're a nerd, you know, because you spent a lot of time. Basketball players are nerds too. Football players, they nerds. Like, you know, like they would think because they don't do a lot of math and they didn't pass this subject. And like, not everybody is good at math and not everybody is good at that subject. So it's like, forget it. Like, for real, you're still a nerd. You're still a geek, my brother. You're still a geek. Auto mechanics, they nerds too. Like, dude, did you see that it had this type of suspension and this and that? You just like, homie, did you see the suspension? You still a nerd. You are still a nerd. That's it. So, okay, so let's talk about Ayurveda. So, that's what it is. So, this is an Ayurvedic daily routine. Wake up when the sun shines. Wake up when the sun rises on Jesse 4. I like to do this because, like, now in the convent, it's like a window. So, you can see, like, it's dark outside and then the sun comes up and it's the window. It's so cute. Wash your face with water, with soap, whatever. Sweet Chef. Scrape your tongue with an Ayurvedic tongue scraper. So, it's like a metal scraper and you don't scrape your tongue. And if you want to know, if you want to know what this is, it'll be on the webpage because I already built the webpage. So, and that like the cost of it is like you get two of them for $5.99. So you got, if you got five people in the house, you see what I'm saying? Like, it's, I put the cheapest ones on there. It's like one where you get like one tongue scraper and you get like the the plastic tongue scrapers or whatever, you know. So I try to put like a variety on there for you, like so $5.99, $4.19, something like that. Oil pulling. So, oh, let's talk about the benefits of tongue scraping, though. Let's see. So, the benefits are you clearing toxins, bacteria, and dead cells from the tongue to prevent bad breath. Enhancing the sense of taste. This is why I like tongue scraping and all this stuff, too, because I am a foodie. Like, I'm really a foodie. Promoting overall oral and digestive health. Gently stimulating the internal organs and increasing your awareness of your state of health. So that's what it is. It's like you just like getting all that like bacteria, all this stuff. So people always say toxins, and it's like it's just really bacteria, because bacteria is what causes and they have a video on her too, like why you would do this every day. But bacteria is what causes odor, you know what I'm saying? So it's like that's all it is. It's like you create, it'll stop cavities. Some of this stuff will actually stop you from having cavities and everything. Like, it's amazing. So, that's the benefits of tongue scraping. The next thing is, like, oil pulling. So, oil pulling is the same thing. You just, like, swish oil in your mouth. You can do sesame seed, coconut, or olive oil. You just swish it in your mouth for, like, 15 to 20 minutes, and then you spit it out into the trash can. They say put it in the trash can because you could stop up the toilet of the sink. But, like, yeah, just spit it into the trash can and that's it. And so that's all you do. It's just, like, again, you just, it's, like, killing bacteria and all this stuff in your mouth. You know, like, one lady was telling me she put tea tree oil over her whole body. She put it in her hair. She put it everywhere. And I was like, it makes sense because it'll stop you from having fungus or small bacteria on you. You see what I'm saying? So one benefit of oil pulling is it can kill harmful bacteria in your mouth. It can reduce bad breath. It helps prevent cavities. It reduces inflammation of the gums. So it offers gum health. And then it says it's many other benefits. You don't need to swallow it. You know, you just swish it in there for 15, 20 minutes. And people usually do it when they first wake up. You don't have to do it when you know what I'm saying? Like, you can do it when you first wake up. Now, this other one, nausea. This is like something where you put it into your nose. It is the entrance for prana, the life force, which is carried into the body through the breath. So it's like this oil, and it's mixed with, I have never heard of some of these oils, eucalyptus brahmi, which is our go-to cola. And then they have another one in there called skullcap, and then calamus. So, the one I really looked up was the banyan nausea oil, because when you look at the ingredients, that's what you wanted to have in there. So, that's the one that has it, but then I put another one on there. And when I put it in a cart, it was actually, like, cheaper. So, what you have to do is lock your head back and drop it in your nostrils. Since I do the neti pot, and I clean my nostrils that way, it's probably something that I would like to do. You see what I'm saying? So you place 3 to 5 drops of nausea in each nostril with that. And then you circle, take a big sniff, wait a few minutes, and you allow the nausea to penetrate. You can also place a drop of nausea oil on your little finger and insert it into your nostril. Gently massage the inner walls of the nasal passage. And you alternate on the nostril. And it's like, that's for better breathing and all this different stuff. So, that's something you can do at home, too. And it's NASYA, nausea. But again, it'll be on the website. And that's it. So, then it's like the final thing that I want to talk about as far as what this is for me. It's like the benefits of Ayurveda self-massage, Abhyanga. So, like, for real. I am... like, I always have, like, this numbness in my hand, so I have to, like, keep peppermint oil, and I have to massage my hands. So, nourishes the entire body, decreases the effects of aging. This is, like, Abhyanga self-massage. It imparts muscle tone and vigor to the tissues of the body, imparts the firmness to the limbs, lubricates the joints, increases circulation, stimulates the internal organs of the body. Assists in elimination of impurities from the body. Moves the lymph, aiding in detoxification. Increases stamina, calms the nerves. Benefits sleep. Better, deeper sleep. Enhances vision. makes her, oh my God. So look, when you do your scalp, you do it this way, and it's like, actually, some of this stuff, you can see it on like some videos and stuff of like how you can like massage your scalp and where to massage it at. You see what I'm saying? Like some of this stuff, like I'm just doing this, but you know, oh God, it feels so good. And it's like, sometimes we don't touch ourselves enough. You spend all day, oh my God, it feels so good. Like you spend all day with yourself and you don't touch yourself. You see what I'm saying? So massage your scalp, softens and smoothens skin, wrinkles are reduced, and disappear, pacifies Vata and Pitta, and stimulates Kapha. So I'm gonna show y'all something else too, because sometimes y'all don't have those little roll balls or whatever, those rollers. You don't have to. You could just like take your hands when you put the, you can massage your face too. So you massage out under your eyes and you go around, because that's like a, this is like your ocular, so it's like a circle. So you know what I'm saying? So it's like, that's how you do that, because that's how the muscles in your face go. And so then it's like out here, and all this stuff will help you with aging too. Y'all see these women like getting these face tucks and stuff, and it's like, this all you really had to do. You see what I'm saying? This all you had to teach your kids. And so that's it. You just, oh, it feels so good. It's like you spend all day with yourself and you don't touch yourself. And so that's it. You know, I don't masturbate. So what? But still, you just touch yourself. That's it. Pacifies Vata and Pitta and stimulates Kapha. So once you learn your dosha, when you go through the dosha quiz, that's why I say you got to do it. I'm a Vata and a Pitta. So it says, you massage your body with love and patience for 15 to 20 minutes. Here are some recommendations for frequency and oil type. So Vata, 4 to 5 times a week, use a sesame almond or Vata balancing oil, such as a relaxing Afi oil. So let's look up an Afi oil. So, did I spell it wrong? I spelled that wrong. Let me just. Abhi oil. I put a P in there. Abhi oil. Abhi oil. And that's it. So it's like, it's really traditionally sesame or coconut oil. So it's just like sesame and coconut oil. That's what they saying. So you can use the sesame and the coconut oil for everything, you know, for the pulling, for this, you know. But that's something like, so you do that 4 to 5 times a week, 15 to 20 minutes. A Pitta, 3 to 4 times a week with coconut, sunflower, or a Pitta balancing oil, again, such as Abhi oil. Kasha dosha, 1 times a week using safflower or Kapha balancing oil, such as an invigorating Abhi oil. Good for all three doshas, jojoba oil. And I don't know if jojoba oil is the one that actually is a part of your skin anyway. But yeah, it's like one of these is like, jojoba oil is a liquid extracted from seeds of a perennial shrub called whatever. The shrub is part of the Buxaxia family that grows in the wild desert of Arizona, California, Mexico, and Egypt. Because jojoba oil has very low levels of triglycerides, it's extraordinarily shelf stable. This makes it an ideal choice for cosmetic products. So it's a natural hydrator for both hair and skin. It's good. It's a good option for acne prone people. That's what it is. It's an inflammatory. It can soothe sunburns. It's a hair strengthener. It's a lightweight cuticle oil. It naturally improves fine lines. It prevents razor burns. It can fade stretch marks and scars. It's a natural makeup remover. So jojoba oil, you know, you can buy it in those little bottles and stuff too. And so you just need a little every day, just to massage yourself. And it's good for everything, your hair, everything. So I know the woman was saying she'd use tea tree oil, but I wouldn't use tea tree. I can't do that. You see what I'm saying? Because me and her are not the... That's why I say sometimes you be like, oh my God, like, these people gonna run me out of business. And it's like, not everybody can do what everybody can do. I can't use tea tree oil, it would burn me. So it's like, y'all have to, like, really stick to what you know. So I was like, nah, I'm better with the peppermint soap. Tea tree oil is not, like, high up there on my list, because all it does is, like, stop bacteria. You see, for me. So for the self-massage, you want to warm the oil, and you could just roll the bottle like this, like back and forth and warm it, and you just sit or stand in a comfortable warm room, like when you, if you're in the shower, but sometimes when it get cold and you get back, you can warm up. Apply the foil or the oil first to the crown of the head and work slowly out in circles. So you see, y'all just do that to the entire scalp. So right here, my head is, it's kind of tender. So it's like you just work slowly and massage it out. Face, it says work in circular motion. Your limbs, you want to use long strokes. Massage the abdomen. And I taught y'all this before, but it's like somebody told me this, you got to go like this. And then you got to push it around so you get all your like little bowel movements and stuff out. You finish the massage by spending at least a couple of minutes massaging your feet, and sit with the oil for 5 to 15 minutes if possible, so that the oil can absorb and penetrate into deeper layers of the skin, and then enjoy your shower or whatever, and make sure you towel off. So the next part of that is sip warm water or herbal tea. Eliminate bowels and bladder. Like I said, then you're going to do your massage. Take 5 deep breaths in meditation. You can do yoga, and then you can have your bath. So that's Ayurvedic daily routine. And so that's it. Like, it's just like, if you're going to be a geek, be a helpful geek. You know what I'm saying? Be somebody that likes what they do. And that's it, y'all. Y'all, please, please, please have the greatest day. That's it. It's Shantae Brown Sugar Talk on the Black Unicorns telling you, Blake, thank you and I love you. I have had a hard day. And it's been 2 days because these people really like stalking. It's like, that is not something you have to do. Stop writing down stuff about me so people can stop. Stop it, because that makes you just as much a stalker as they are. Have a good day.